Hi, welcome to this PractiTest tutorial video, where we'll cover the basic testing functionality within the system. Today, we'll show you how to create and manage your test cases, how to group these tests into test sets, and how to run them in order to log your steps, submit the issues you find, and report your results. Let's start by talking for a minute about the two testing modules you'll find within PractiTest. The first module is called the Test Library. This is your test repository, or the place where you can create and manage your test cases. The second module is called the Test Sets and Runs. This is where you group your test cases into test sets and run them. The idea behind these two modules is to encourage reusability and make sure that you can run each test you write in the library multiple times throughout different releases or even within the same release to check the system, for example, under different browsers or mobile devices or other factors like that. Now, let's go back to the test library and create a new test. When we create a test, we start by filling out the information about it, details like the test's name and a short description. We can also choose to fill out information about our test with the help of PractiTest's custom fields, here. By the way, if you already have automated tests, you can link them to your scripts here and have PTXBot execute them for you. Notice that all the fields in this area can be customized as part of your project setup, and that they'll help organize your test cases using filter trees. This is the best and most flexible way to manage thousands of tests instead of the old test tree approach. For more information on this, go to our Hierarchical Filter Tree video. Now we can go and add some steps to our test. Each step can have a name, a description, and expected results. You can also add attachments to your steps to be shown during runtime to your testers. Attachments can be anything you need, for example, images to verify the GUI of your application, or even data you want to provide to your testers for their use in complex scenarios. You can have as many steps as you like, and you can also import tests and steps from spreadsheets. Once your test is created, you can choose to link it to an existing requirement in order to set up its traceability. Remember that you can also link tests to requirements from the requirements module. Now that we've created our test, we can go ahead and run it by going to our Test Sets and Runs module. What we have in here are test sets. Test sets are a group of tests that you want to run together for any given reason. For example, it may be that these are tests that cover a specific feature, or you want to run them during a given sprint or cycle. Or maybe you have a part of your regression test suite that you want to group and run together every 2 weeks during your release process. Or maybe what you have in there is your nightly automation test sets that you update in PractiTest directly from your CI system using our APIs. Let's go ahead and create a new test set. Each set will have a name and information captured using custom fields. Now we can add test instances from the test library to it. To do that, we click here to choose any of the tests from our project to be added into our set. You can use the filters you created in the library to help you find the test. Once we've located the tests we want, we add them into our set. Now you can reorder them based on your logical execution flow by clicking on this link here. To run our test set, you can go to any of the tests and click the Run button, or with this button over here. Your tester will be taken to this screen, where he or she sees all the steps to run. Now let's pretend to be a tester. Assume that I ran each of my tests and all of them passed. So right here, I mark them one by one as passed. I can then use this button to choose the next test to run in my set, or simply press this button and it'll take me directly to the next test in the queue. Now let's assume again that I was running this test. The first step passed, but then I found a bug in my second step. So I'll start by logging the actual result that I got with the bug that I found. Now, what I want to do is report a new issue in the system for this bug. To do this, I click on this link that takes me directly to PractiTest's issue module. There, it reports the bug, using all the information that I captured up to now from my test. It'll repopulate the name of the bug and the steps to reproduce it, and I'll be able to add as much additional information as I want, customized based on my project. Once I'm done and I want to go back to continue my test, I just click on this link here, and I'm taken back to my test where I see that the status of my step has been set to failed, and the bug that I reported has been linked directly to the step where I found it. Now I can continue running my test as usual. Take into account that if you're working with another bug tracking system, such as Jira, Pivotal Tracker, or a number of other systems, you can also integrate these with PractiTest and report the bugs the same way into your system, while linking them back into PractiTest. You can learn more about this by visiting our support portal. Last, I want to show you an additional feature that's really useful, especially on dynamic teams where tests are constantly evolving and being updated. Sometimes you need to update the steps of a test after you've already started running it. If this happens, you have what we call step actions that will allow you to update a step or even add or remove a step within your test. Let's say that I wanted to add a new step between this one here and this one. I choose to add a step below it, and a new step is added to my test. Now I can fill out the fields, and once I'm done, I click on this button to update my step. Now at this point, I only updated my specific run, but if I want to update the original test in the test library, I can simply click on this button here. I can now continue running my steps, and when I'm done, I can go to the next test in the queue, or back to my test set, by clicking on this link. As always with PractiTest, your results are updated live. You can see the status of your tests in the test set, you can see the status of your test in the test library, and even the updated status of your requirements in the requirements module. This is what we call end-to-end traceability and coverage for your project. You can also go to your dashboard and see how you can provide live visibility into your project for all your internal and external stakeholders, around the clock and around the globe. We invite you to take a look at some of our additional videos at youtube.com/practitest, where we explore more aspects of the system, such as our filter trees, dashboards, customizations, and more.